cockabye, dogmen, cynocephali, enderata, garmido, cannibals, therkai, alanai, pisalon, denkai, seltrai. At the end of the world and at the final consummation, when men are eating and drinking and marrying wives, and women are given to husbands, when they are planting vineyards and building buildings, and there is neither wicked man nor adversary on account of the assured tranquility and certain peace, suddenly the gates of the north shall be opened.
ห่วงครับผมเข้าใจว่าสถานการณ์ช่วงนี้มันไม่ดีขึ้นแต่ว่าเราต้องออกมาแสดงว่าเรารู้สึกไม่พอใจกับมาตรการที่รัฐเอาออกมาเหมือนเขาแค่ทำแค่เหมือนแค่อยากให้หยุดทุกอย่างหยุดแต่เขาไม่หาเหตุผลที่จะแก้นั้นในต้นเหตุให้ได้ครับผมเข้าใจว่าตอนนี้มันเสี่ยงเพราะโรคมันระบาดเยอะเราพยายามป้องกันตัวทุกอย่างถุงมือหน้ากากแก๊สทุกอย่างครับผมกันทุกอย่างเพื่อให้มันเกิดผลกระทบต่อเราน้อยที่สุดครับ
เรารู้สึกได้รับผลกระทบที่รัฐบาลการ management อย่างเงี้ยเขา management ไม่ค่อยได้เรื่องสักเท่าไหร่แล้วเราก็เห็นมันมากระทบกับเราในปีนี้ซึ่งเราก็เลยคิดว่าถ้าเราไม่ทำอะไรอย่างเงี้ยมันก็จะยังเป็นคงแบบนี้ต่อไปเราต้องการการบริหารที่มันแบบup to date หน่อยคือดูชาวบ้านกันบ้างว่าไปถึงไหนแล้วไม่ใช่ว่ายังจะคงแบบ
Accept transgender customers. A protester was shot at close range by an officer with a less lethal shotgun. So did he violate use of force policy? Eyewitness News reporter Amy Powell has more.
This incident and the viral video raising questions about the LAPD's use of force during a protest in Koreatown. An LAPD officer seen on video firing a less than lethal round at close range, striking one of the protesters in the stomach. She falls to the ground. This happening after opposing groups of protesters gathered near the intersection of Wilshire and Rampart in Koreatown on Saturday, clashing over transgender access to a spa. According to authorities, protesters started throwing bottles and other projectiles, some of them pelted at officers. An order was issued telling the crowd to disperse. When some refused to leave the area, police used less than lethal force. But a law enforcement expert says he doesn't understand what prompted the use of that weapon.
There were some projectiles that were being thrown at
the court. As acquitted the sole accused in the case of all charges, the court said that testimonies of witnesses.
Every one of them.
Anger. And arrests. The protesters started gathering at Victoria Park near Sydney University, police on foot and on horseback trying to corral the crowd, numbers growing by the minute into the thousands. Former footballer and boxer Anthony Mundine, spotted without a mask at a hardware store this week, was barefaced again with his personal message.
Where's your mask today?
I'm exempt.
Do you believe in the public health orders, Anthony?
No.
Suddenly, the aim of containing the crowd turned into direct action.
No!
Freedom for some, but it was a nightmare unfolding in front of those trying to contain Sydney's COVID crisis.
Police are trying to stop these crowds from marching into the city. What we have here is a standoff. We have thousands of people defying the orders and continuing to walk, and they'll be met by mounted police.
Blocking traffic, the crowd pushed on down Broadway. Health authorities, police and the government were the target, but the fury had no boundaries.
Tell the truth! Tell the truth!
Officers by now had little choice but to at least try to contain and direct the flow of protesters.
Buak
tout prix nous obliger à se faire vacciner. Donc non. J'ai plus de travail, j'ai 48 ans, je ne vais pas refaire une reconversion professionnelle, j'en ai plus la force.
Donc ils n'ont qu'à me licencier, je m'en fous. Ils n'ont qu'à nous licencier, ceux qui ne veulent pas se vacciner, ils n'ont qu'à nous licencier.
Sur le moment, ma première réaction, j'étais furieuse parce que je trouve que c'est un peu abusé, surtout que c'était pas très bien expliqué. Je ne le savais pas. Mais après réflexion, je me suis calmée, je me suis dit, je comprends, c'est une logique médicale et s'il faut être rigoureux, ben soyons rigoureux. Donc là, je vais trouver une pharmacie, me faire tester pour avoir un PCR négatif et revenir. Et ils m'ont dit que mon billet qui était normalement pour 10h30 serait encore valable. Du coup, toute la journée, il ferait une tolérance.
Have received no relief for days. The roads have been closed and all trucks with the usual supplies have simply not been able to reach them. The shops themselves have either been looted or are closed up because the owners are afraid that they could be ransacked in the coming days. Now here you can see a grocery warehouse that has been completely looted and burned down. All the concrete steel slabs have been melted down in the fire that was set alight here. Today is the first day that one or two shops in the town have opened. Most people are still staying at home, and as you can see, these shops are all boarded closed. People are still afraid amongst rumors that the violence is going to erupt anytime again.
At the moment, I'm so sorry, because for our safety, it's still not safe out there. There are still words going out there that there's still danger. So we're just trying to do our best to serve the community.
Here is one of the first shops to open, but its owner, Zahid, is still assessing the damage. He says he was lucky to escape with his life intact.
People loot everything in the shop, even single piece of bread loaf, everything he took it away. For me, the situation right now is little bit better, but I still no get a stock, and my shop is all is finished. Even you can see that fridge is empty, all some folding I just buy yesterday and put it here.
We're now in the town of Isipingo, which has also been completely looted. We're accompanying a shop owner who hasn't been able to reach the town since the violence started.
Que hay con el pueblo, que nos tienen matándonos de hambre, donde toda la Habana entera se está derrumbando y estamos sin casa, sin nada. Tienen dinero para construir hoteles, para construir de todo. A nosotros nos tienen pasando hambre y tremendo trabajo.
En nuestro pueblo habrá una respuesta revolucionaria. Y por eso también aquí estamos convocando a todos los revolucionarios del país, a todos los comunistas, a que salgan a las calles en cualquiera de los lugares donde se vayan a producir estas provocaciones.
Anger over coronavirus restrictions. In Athens, Greek police tried to break up protests against compulsory COVID-19 vaccinations. Some in the crowd threw petrol bombs. The police responded with tear gas. The rally outside the Greek parliament was the third this month against mandatory inoculations for some workers, including healthcare and nursing staff.
This is not an anti-vaccine movement. These are people that have thought about it and want their freedom.
The mood was the same at a demonstration in Paris. There, tear gas filled the air as protesters opposed to a government virus pass faced off against riot police. This was just one of dozens of mainly peaceful rallies across the country, which brought up more than 160,000 people. The French plan requires all healthcare workers be vaccinated, and for everyone else to prove their virus or vaccination status in order to enter restaurants and other cultural venues.
We need to wait a little bit before the French people can decide. I feel we're being rushed. It's only been 6 months since these vaccines were made available, and it feels like the French people are being forced with blackmail. I think a part of France is always going to be unwilling, and blackmail and threats won't work.
I think systematic vaccination is too extreme and too risky, and I'm also very shocked by the extension of this to children.
Police during anti-lockdown demonstrations in Sydney, Australia on Saturday. Thousands of people, mostly maskless, gathered in defiance of public health orders amidst a growing COVID-19 outbreak. The protests turned violent fairly quickly as demonstrators threw potted plants, paint and water bottles at police officers and media, while others physically assaulted police horses. New South Wales Police Minister David Elliott announced the formation of a strike force to identify and charge those involved.
What we saw today were 3,500 very selfish bullheads.
People that thought that the law didn't apply to them. There is no doubt in my mind that at least one individual there today.
At least 57 people were arrested at Sydney's protest, with many more expected to come. Whilst in the neighbouring state, Victoria, local media reported at least half a dozen were arrested in Melbourne.
Less people marched through Australia's most populous city, waving Australian flags and also chanting. The demonstrators flouted rules of non-essential travel and public gatherings just a day after the authorities suggested that restrictions could actually remain in place until the month of October. So the protest turned violent fairly quickly as the protesters threw potted plants and water bottles at the police officers. Some others physically assaulted the police horses, and at least about 57 people were arrested at the protest. The demonstration came as COVID-19 case numbers in the state have reached another record.